Graduation is only a concept. In real life, one graduates every day. Graduation is a process that goes on till the end of time and life. And if you can grasp that, you can make a difference. Limitations live only in our minds, but if we use our imaginations, our possibilities become limitless. वो खुद ही नाप लेते हैं बुलंदी आसमानों की वो खुद ही नाप लेते हैं बुलंदी आसमानों की परिंदे को नहीं तालीम दी जाती उड़ानों की महकना और महकाना तो काम है खुशबू का महकना और महकाना तो काम है खुशबू का खुशबू नहीं मोहताज होती कदरदानों की A very good morning to the galaxy of intellectuals present in this August gathering of the virtual convocation 2022 ceremony of FMSIRM. Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. M.P. Punia, President SIIRM, Professor Barbara Kangan, Distinguished Guest of Honor, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahuguna,
Dr. Ashutosh Pant, Chairperson, Stakeholders Relationship Committee, Indian Oil Corporation Limited and Chairman Shailja Foundation, Dr. N.K. Sharma, Principal Investigator, MRP, UGC Department of Economic Administration and Financial Management, Dr. Stanley Thomas Kangan, Secretary SIIRM, Officiating Registrar, Mr. T.C. Jain, Director FMSIRM, Dr. Tarjini Goyal, all the members of the various bodies of SIIRM, Board of Studies, Academic Council, Council of Directors of FMSIRM,
faculty members, the graduates, parents and guardians, alumni, guests and dear students. I, Dr. Tanya Soin Gaurav, welcome you all to the 19th convocation ceremony of FMSIRM. हे शारदे माँ हे शारदे माँ भाषा पर मुझको अधिकार दे माँ भावों का नया संसार दे माँ कलम को मेरी संस्कार दे माँ शब्दों का मुझको भंडार दे माँ कल्पनाओं को नए आधार दे माँ Buddha once said, if you light the lamp for others, it will brighten the path for you. So with this wish, let's seek the blessings of Ma Saraswati and kindle the lamp for our future and the future of our budding managers. I would request the dignitaries to proceed for the lighting of the lamp ceremony. थैंक यू अतिथि सत्कार बिना हर अरदास अधूरी होती है अतिथि सत्कार बिना हर अरदास अधूरी होती है अतिथि ही वो फरिश्ते हैं जिनके आने से आस पूरी होती है पावर इज इन कंट्रोल एट ऑल पावर इज स्ट्रेंथ एंड गिविंग दैट स्ट्रेंथ टू अदर्स अ लीडर इज इन समवन हु फोर्सेस अदर्स टू मेक हिम स्ट्रॉन्गर A leader is someone willing to give his strength to others that they may have the strength to stand on their own. It is my honor to introduce the visionaries present in this August gathering of virtual convocation of FMSIRM. Our chief guest, Dr. M.P. Punia, Vice Chairman, All India Council for Technical Education. Dr. M.P. Punia, an IIT alumnus, specialized in the field of mechanical engineering, renewable energy, and sustainable development. He possesses a vast experience of 30 years, over 90 published papers, 10 books, and development of 2 manuals to his credit. He is the recipient of various laurels and awards, a few being Bharat Mata Award conferred by Indian Institute of Oriental Heritage and National Award for the Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities. Dr. Punia has also made significant contribution for the growth and development of technical education in the northern states of India and sub-regional and in-country programs in collaboration with Colombo Plant Staff College for Technician Education, Manila, Philippines. Dr. Punia emphasizes on quality education, good governance, e-learning towards digital India, Go Green Environment, skill development, and has also assisted UGC, NBA, NAC, Consortium for Educational Communication, and Telecom Sector Skill Council of India for their achievements. He is an advisor of the Sustainable Business Network of United Nations SCAP, Business Advisory Council, and also a member of ISTE and Society of Automotive Engineers. Sir, it's an honor to be in your presence and have you with us this morning. With immense pride, I introduce to you our guest of honor, who is also our alumnus, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahuguna. A management strategist with over 23 years of enriched achievements in agriculture input industry, currently he is leading sales and marketing agriculture for India, SAARC and SEA region for Momentive Performance Materials India Private Limited. He is the recipient of various awards, few being Walk the Talk Innovation Award, SQD Global Achievement Award, and the Inspire Award. He co-authored a chapter on Kyosi and India in a book by Mr. G.P. Rao, Mr. Madan, and Dr. Thomas Kangan on HRD, a value-based approach. Mr. Bahuguna is also the co-inventor of a silicon-based soil wetting agent presently under patent registration in the U.S. They say that it takes a beautiful human to be inclined towards art. Our guest of honor is adept in fine arts. Sir, we are fortunate to have you as a guest of honor on this auspicious ceremony. It has been an honor for me to introduce our esteemed guests. Their vast experience, achievements, and contributions has brought back to my mind the lines of a poem by Robert Frost. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep, but I have promises to keep. And miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep.
May I request the registrar to seek the permission of the president to declare the e-convocation open.
Madam President, the 19th e-convocation of the Faculty of Management Studies, Institute of Rural Management, has been called to confer the diploma upon the candidates who have been found worthy by the Council of Directors. If permitted, this 19th e-convocation be declared open.
As requested, the organization of the convocation ceremony could not be held in the person due to COVID scenario. It was decided to hold it through e-platform. Therefore, by the power vested in me as the president of the Institute of Rural Management, I grant permission to declare this e-convocation open.
Permission of the President, I hereby declare the e-convocation open.
Youth and vision can unleash immense potential and development. I would like to invite the dynamic and enterprising Dr. Stanley Thomas Kangan, Secretary SIIRM, for the welcome address.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, distinguished guests, dear students, and the family and friends, it's an honor for me to propose a formal welcome address for the 19th convocation of FMS IRM. I would like to begin by expressing my sincere gratitude to all the dignitaries at the dais who took out time from their extremely busy schedule to be with us and share their wisdom and their insightful addresses. Your presence here today demonstrates your commitment to education in a continuously evolving world. The graduation day is a very special day for all the students. It is a pious occasion where the hard work of the students, the sacrifices of their parents, and the dedication of their faculty all comes to fruition. On behalf of the entire teaching fraternity here at FMS IRM, I would like to congratulate each and every one of you and wish you the very best in all your future endeavors. It is my privilege to welcome the esteemed dignitaries who have graced today's occasion. Our chief guest, Professor M.P. Punia, guests of honor, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahuguna, along with Dr. Ashutosh Pant and Dr. N.K. Sharma, Professor Barbara Kangan, President SIRM, Dr. T.C. Jain, Member SIRM, members of the Governing Council, Board of Studies, Academic Council, and various other committees, faculty and staff, media team, and other invitees. I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. It is my honor to say a few words about our chief guest, Professor M.P. Punia. Professor M.P. Punia is Vice Chairman, All India Council for Technical Education, New Delhi. He is an IIT alumnus and a specialist in mechanical engineering and renewable energy. He has a vast experience in various fields from engineering to social development. He has over 90 papers, 10 books, and a number of lab manuals published to his credit. He is a recipient of various laurels and awards, including national awards for the empowerment of persons with disabilities. His efforts for the growth and development of technical education in India and other countries like Manila and Philippines are truly exceptional. Sir, we are truly honored to have you with us today. With immense pride, we welcome our guest of honor, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahuguna. Mr. Sushil Bahuguna completed his graduation in agriculture and animal husbandry from Govind Vallabh Pant Krishi Evam Prayogik Vishwavidyalaya with flying colors and completed his master's from FMS IRM itself. With the experience and expertise of 20 years in agri-input industry, he has created a position for himself as an expert in specialty chemicals for agriculture. He joined Momentum Performance Materials India Private Limited as sales and marketing leader, agriculture, SAARC and SEA region. He is working intensively for the cause of rural farmers and farming through various initiatives. We are extremely happy to welcome a renowned personality who is also an alumnus of FMS IRM. Welcome again to your alma mater, sir. I would also like to welcome Dr. Ashutosh Pant, Chairman, Stakeholders Relationship Committee, Indian Oil Corporation, and Chairman, Shailja Foundation, along with Dr. N.K. Sharma, Principal Investigator, MRP UGC, Department of Economic Administration and Financial Management, for taking out time from their extremely busy schedule to be with us here today. In closing, I would like to extend a special word of thanks to the proud parents, relatives, and friends for the encouragement they gave to our students throughout their studies, and also a special congratulations to all our valued graduates on the immense success you all have achieved and have made all of us so very proud. Godspeed. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. It is always a matter of pride for any HOI to put across every step, big or small, taken by the institution. I invite Dr. Tarjini Goyal, Director FMS IRM, for the presentation of the annual report for the academic year 2020-21.
Honorable Chief Guest of the occasion, Shri M.P. Puniaji, respected Guest of Honor, Shri Sushil Kumar Bahugunaji, Madam President, SIIRM, Professor Barbara Kangan, CEO and Secretary SIRM, all the HOIs of the various SIRM institutions, respected dignitaries, on and off the dais, distinguished members of the various committees of FMS, and respected recruiters, faculty members, staff members, parents, alumni, and distinguished invited guests. It is my great honor and privilege to welcome one and all here present on behalf of the Institute and on my own behalf to this auspicious and solemn occasion of the 19th convocation ceremony of FMSIRM. At the outset, I offer my heartiest congratulations to each one of you, that is the graduates, who are present online and those who could not attend but will be getting the diplomas in absentia, for their hard work, their parents and guardians for the sacrifices made, and the faculty members for spending their time in mentoring them to complete their studies successfully and timely. Special congratulations to all the medal winners and their parents for their achievements. I also express my sincere appreciation to the staff members of FMSIRM for their assistance and to make the Institute a place of excellence and fine achievements. Today, we are offering diplomas to the students of both the disciplines, that is PGDM and PGDM-RM. I'm extremely happy to present the annual report of the year 2020-21 for the Institute of Rural Management, which was established in the year 1994 by our founder president, Dr. Thomas Kangan sir. In the span of 3 decades, the Institute has got a very high visibility and has been recognized as an institute that has evolved in a very high quality teaching and research in diverse fields. FMSIRM offers 2 programs, that is, Postgraduate Diploma in Management and Postgraduate Diploma in Rural Management. Being the pioneer institute to offer PGDM-RM program, we have gained wide recognition both at national and international level, and among both public and private sectors in general and agri-business allied sectors in particular. The PGDM program of the Institute has received NBA accreditations under the Washington Accord and has been recognized by AIU, which places the Institute among the top rankings in the country. As the premier institute of Rajasthan in management, the focus of the Institute is not on anything normal, but on perfection. With this zeal and enthusiasm, we have set a series of goals for our Institute for ensuring the academic excellence, focusing more of quality admissions, and developing international linkages. In the span of almost 3 decades, we have emerged as an institute with distinction, an ever-learning and promising institute, providing values, quality education in management with a vision towards excellence. The very foundation of the institute is based on the philosophy of education, whose cardinal principle is resourcefulness and self-sufficiency, with special focus on the upliftment of the underprivileged, especially in the rural areas, by providing basic education in general and professional education in particular. This academic year will be remembered in the academic arena as a year impacted by coronavirus pandemic, which has jolted on the academic life of the Institute, which has swept away our best plans for everyday life at the Institute. The Institute quickly prepared itself for the national and local lockdowns that followed. In these moments of crisis, we drew inspiration from the values set by our founder presidents and set ourselves on 2 objectives. First, to keep our students, faculty, and staff safe from the risk of infection. And secondly, to ensure that we sustain our intensive academic calendar. We worked overtime to mitigate rapidly to an online academic program, innovated around all our
examination practices and ensured that we have remarkable terms and high levels of students' attendance, exams, and successful completions of the course. It is due to the remarkable efforts of the faculty and staff members and students that we have achieved these outstanding results and are here today to conduct our 19th annual convocation on the scheduled date. Following the pedagogy, with more emphasis on case studies and simulation exercises based on virtual and online requirements due to the pandemic, IRM implemented the protocol for conducting proctored online examinations, both for midterm as well as the end term examinations. We also conducted the scheduled NISM NCF examinations on the dates. This year, we have secured AAA ranking and have been ranked among top institutes in Rajasthan and India based on the rankings published. This includes the official ranking from India Today, Outlook, The Week, Career 360, and Education World, among others. Amidst the COVID scenario, the institute offered corporate interface and had almost 46 companies who visited us from various sectors such as FMCG, FMCD, banking, KPO, microfinances, development sectors, and many more. The number of companies who visited us for summer internships were 27 in number. All the students got the opportunity to do summer and winter internships. Academic initiatives have always been a high priority in the institute. The syllabi was continuously updated and new courses were added. Academic Council and the Board of Studies have representations from industry in addition to the academicians from top academic institutions. Industry-academia interactions have been very strong in the institute. Industry experts regularly visit campus for delivering lecture and as advisors and members in various committees of the institute. The institute adopted new academic and examination regulations for both the academic programs. In the line of new education policy, IRM introduced choice-based credit system and made changes in the various subjects. These changes were introduced keeping in record and in mind the current business scenarios. Academic development through certification programs was made compulsory component for various portals such as SWAM, MOOC, Coursera, Udemy, etc. for developing the skill sets of the students in various areas. Students of the batches have been linked with digital library at IIT Kharagpuri. Last year has witnessed a great focus on research building facilities augmented by funding agencies and various national and national agencies. Faculty members of the institute have actively involved themselves in research and consultancy projects. Faculty development programs were organized keeping this requirement in mind. Outcome-based education, that is OBE, and its implementation in teaching and evaluation was one among them. Faculty development programs on various subjects have been organized by the institute. As a result, during the past 1 year, faculty members have published research papers in peer review journals at national and international level. Several faculty members of the institutes received various academic collaborations and recognitions. With much of humbleness and pride, I am submitting that the faculty members have international publications in IEEE, Emerald, and international publications in ABDC listings. We have also introduced 11 clubs with an objective to make learning a fun activity, and that too in campus life. The various clubs that have been introduced are Symphony Club, Thinking Hat Clubs, Finance Club, that is FinWin Club, Sharing Smile Clubs to promote the CSR activities, Pick Makeka Club, Achar Vichar Club, Let's Click Club, Alumni Association Club, Aram the Entrepreneurship Club. Even the impact of COVID could not hinder our enthusiasm, and we concluded various major events under these clubs, such as Dance Mania, Finance Quiz, B Plan Competitions, brand mix and match that has been done by Marketing Marvels Club, union budget analysis, various kinds of CSR activities such as say trees to promote an implantation of trees, mock trading competitions, tribal day celebrations, Nukkar Natak's, all these were performed under the strict COVID guidelines. Alumni have been the backbone of the institute, and with the objective to enhance the skills of the students and acquainting them about the corporate arena, the alumni members helped us on various platforms, especially Rendezvous, the alumni talk series. This platform enhanced the bonding between the alumni and the institute and also provided a place for the current students to interact with their senior alumni members. On the, some of the topics that were covered under the ATS were Indian retail sector and insider perspective, corporate expectations post COVID-19, global networking from LinkedIn and beyond, building resilience during pandemic, what they don't teach at business school, conquering insurance industry with digital marketing, accelerating sales and modern selling approaches, role of SIP and specializations on final placements, decoding B2B. During this year, a galaxy of top dignitaries and academicians from India and abroad shared their rich experiences. The list of such dignitaries is too large to be read out here. But to name a few, we had Sri Bunker Roy, social entrepreneur and founder, Barefoot College, Thelonia. Sri Udesh Kohli Ji, Global Impact, United Nations. Mr. Abhay Jeri, CIO, Ministry of Education. Mr. Upinder Dhar, Vice Chancellor, Sri Vaishnav Vidyapeeth, Indore. Mr. Amitav Chatterjee, Director, Cognizant, UK. Mr. Dheeraj Agarwal, Senior Vice President and CEO, Manappuram Finance. Mr. Vinay Bagri, CEO and Founder, Neon Solutions. We had some international guests during this tenure, and they were Mr. Sanjay Gupta, Social Entrepreneur at Dubai, Mr. Satish Kumbhat, Senior Analyst at PPP Healthcare, US, Dr. Gopal Iyer, associated with Newcastle University, UK, Mr. Gautam Bhattacharyaji, Technology General Manager and R&D at P&G China, Mr. Obey Verghese, Sales Director at Michiko Group, UAE, Mr. Harsh Upadhyay, Senior Sales Enablement Partner, LinkedIn, Singapore. We had some guests from of the national repute also, Mr. Ankur Srivastav, business head at Bajaj Auto Limited, Mr. Vivek Srivastav, head of the business at Benetton India, Mr. Gaurav Sabu, head finance, BMW Industries, Mr. Samrat Ghosh, associate vice president, ICICI Lombard, Mr. Manish Mishra, manager sales, Samsung Electronics, and the list goes on. This year visualized and had a couple of trainings conducted for students on various topics such as digital marketing, an opportunity in association with Sophia Girls College Ajmer, seminar on the budgets, training programs in communication skills, and ISM seminars, webinars on the importance of financial planning, webinars on changing trends in development sector, GST and recent changes, and self-assessment for better placements. During the past 1 year, the institute signed 12 MOUs with various institutions, research labs, and industrial establishments. The institute has increased its infrastructure facility like lecture halls, sports and recreational facilities, etc. The students are encouraged to participate in the extracurricular activities which run parallel to the academic programs. New sport places has been also constructed in the campus premises. The institute takes its social responsibility very seriously and ensures that no qualified applicant is denied higher education for the want of financial resources. It is with a feeling of great pride and honor to report to this August gathering that in recognition to the outstanding contribution towards the society and for providing quality education, a scholarship of 1 crore were offered to the students. I'm also happy to share that amidst the times of crisis in 2021, the Institute is awarded as Outstanding Institute in Digital Innovations, Technology and Best Practices for the New Normal Education Leadership Summit Award 2021. As an institute, our aims are more advanced and we are striving for AMBA and AACBS accreditations. Also, to initiate with new training centers with focus on agri-entrepreneurial development. Till now, 32 batches have successfully completed their course. 33rd and 34th batch are pursuing the academics in the ongoing year. Thus, IRM has given around 4,000 plus qualified managers and professionals to the corporate world, state and central government, microfinancial institutions, and various NGOs globally. I request all the dignitaries present here to extend their support and guidance in our endeavor to reach academic excellence and to attain our vision and become an institute of global repute. We are proud to send our new graduates off to the world as trained and motivated citizens. We do hope that the students, after graduating from the institute, will reach the zenith of their career and will become great citizens who will make the world a better place to live. I once again congratulate the parents and the students who have been a part of this function and have received the degrees and medals of appreciation for their achievements. I'm sure the junior batch of the students would have great inspirations from the success stories of their seniors. Before I conclude, I would like to call upon the students who have received their diplomas today and say that as you step out into the world, do not be contented with the initial academic instructions that you have imbibed here. Always aim high and dream deep. All our dreams come true if we have the courage to pursue them. If you believe in yourself and you have the courage and determination, dedication, the competitive drive, and if you have the feeling to sacrifice the little things in life and pay the prices of the things that are worthwhile, you can achieve everything that you dreamed of. You must remember that success is not final and failure is not forever. May God bless you all. We wish you very bright, happy, and prosperous future ahead. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you, ma'am.
I invite our chief guest, Sri M.P. Punia, for delivering the convocation address.
Good morning. Respected Professor Babra Kangan, president of this very, very prominent Institute of State of Rajasthan. Sushil Kumar Bhagunaji, who is guest of honor in this convocation, 19th convocation of IRM Institute. Dr. T.C. Jain, Dr. Asutosh Pant, young Dr. Steny Thomas, N.K. Sharmaji, Madam Tarjini Goyal, who is director of this institute, all the prominent members, all the students who are connected for receiving these degrees, the parents, first of all, whole team of IRM has to be congratulated, the wonderful, wonderful contribution for the betterment of society. The way this annual report of the institute, it has been gone through, it is marvelous. My best wishes to everyone. Keep on doing good work, and society is having enormous, enormous expectations from this type of institute. I was connected from IRM since years, since the time of late Thomas Kanganji, and great start in the state of Rajasthan. With his hands, it has been done, and same with same rhythm and same zeal, enthusiasm, the team is doing a great job. So everyone, it has to be congratulated. Very long introduction of mine, it has been given. Longer the introduction, smaller the person always. जिस व्यक्ति का जितना लंबा परिचय होता है वो व्यक्ति हमेशा इतना ही छोटा होता है। एंड महात्मा गांधी जी वाज इन साबरमती आश्रम, इट इज इन गुजरात, एंड ही वाज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ही वाज अवे फ्रॉम साबरमती आश्रम बिकॉज ही वाज फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट ब्रिटिशर्स एंड प्लानिंग डूइंग एक्ट सो दैट इमीडिएटली दे शुड बी एबल टू मूव फ्रॉम द कंट्री। दैट टाइम लॉन्ग बैक ही हैज रिसीव्ड वन पोस्ट कार्ड and that has been written by Australian, one of the Australian citizen, and it is not important what contents it has been in that postcard, but today if you are visiting Sabarmati Ashram, that past postcard is lying on the wall of the Sabarmati Ashram. Probably that Australian citizen has given some suggestions to Mahatma Gandhiji that in what way he's planning it has to be, so that freedom to country can be obtained at the earliest possible. But the address which is written on that postcard, it is Gandhi, India. Letter starts from Australia, came to India, went to Gujarat and finally to Sabarmati Ashram, and introduction of Gandhiji was just Gandhi, India. My best wishes to every student of IRM community that our introduction is longer, it hardly matters, more or less we people have played our inning, but this young population, the young boys and girls who have been trained here, their introduction should be just like IRM India. Wherever they go, they should be recognized by this introduction, this complete introduction, IRM India. So at this particular juncture, I'll be congratulating the students who are getting degrees, the success certificate of the success they are getting. Now they are eligible to enter into world of work. They are now ready to do actions. Management education, which they have taken, it is incomplete without actions. So now you'll be completing your targets, the dreams which you people are having, and fulfilling the dreams of the society. We want every graduate who is coming out, they should be technically sound. When I'm saying technically sound, the type of education which it has been imparted to them, they should be able to do justice with that one. Technically sound, and second one, they should be professionally competent. Any profession where they were, they'll be joining, they should be able to do justice with that assignment which has been given to them. So technically they should be sound in their core strength, professionally they should be competent, their soft skills, their attitude, their behavior, their dedication, their sincerity, their transparency, and finally they should be socially relevant. Important part is in what way our graduates, our young boys and girls who are the part of this higher education system, when they are coming into the market, how they are bringing happiness on the faces of the citizens of the country, and not only our country. A director of the institute was saying, Rajini was saying, that we provide that type of environment so that the graduates, not only they'll be serving our nation, across the globe, they should be able to bring happiness on the faces of the citizens of the globe. That type of expectation we people are having. In our country, it is a very huge population base. Our population is 1.4 billion. And world's population is 7 billion. Out of 7 billion, we people, we Indians are 1.4 billion. If I'm doing a small calculation, 7 divided by 1.4, the figure which we are receiving, it is 5. It means every fifth person on this globe is an Indian. Our dream is, our target is, that our strengths should be able to move across the globe with our strong traditions which we people were having, our family system, our values, our sanskaras, our core competencies, our ability to lead the teams. With that, they should be able to prove across the globe that we Indians are something different and we can take any sort of challenge which is in front of the society. That sort of confidence we people will have to build, and those graduates, if we are strong human resource with this message that we Indian are something different. In lieu of that one, in lieu of working across the globe, if they can bring dollars for this country, country will be growing. If this strong young population which we are having, they are just like human beings, if they can be converted into strong human resource, socially relevant human resource, and if they can bring dollars for this country, country will be growing only if we'll be having a strong base of our gross domestic product. Our infrastructure, our education system, our health system, our communication, everything will be strengthened. It will be converting our human beings into human resource. The challenges, the strong challenges, which are there, the dreams is this young population which you are having, youth, they are having, fulfilling their dreams. They are not ordinary strength. They are not average strength. Their dreams are very, very high. From 40 years back, if you have imagination or if you have see the history of the country, 40 years back, our friends used to dream that if I can see US, if I can see Canada, if I can see European country, that type of dream they were having some 40 years back. 30 years back, they started dreaming that if I can enter into US, if I can earn some degrees in US, if I can study in US, and that dream also started fulfilling. 20 years back, they started dreaming that if I can work in US, if I can become a citizen of US, and if I can contribute for their economy or probably economy of the globe, but because that platform will be stronger, so if I can serve there, that type of dream our graduates were having. From 10 years back, again, that dream, it has changed. Our friends started dreaming that if I can become CEO for any of the organization, just like Microsoft or Twitter or Cisco, that type of friends started dreaming. Continuously, dreams were changing, reached up to the level of CEO. But now, students which we are having in our country, the students who are graduating today from IRM, their dreams are not an ordinary dream. They would like to become CEO, but they would like to become CEOs of those companies who have taken birth into our institutes, in our country, in those type of companies they want to become CEOs. So fulfilling those dreams, वो चाहते हैं कि भारत के अंदर भारतीय universities के अंदर कंपनियों का जन्म हो, उसके हम CEO बने, ऐसे बच्चों को orienting them, molding them, giving direction, it's a very, very, very serious challenge. And we teachers, role of teachers are very, very important. Whatever dream they are having, our responsibility is to fulfill those dreams. So role of teachers, it's very important. And orienting this young population into right direction. One side we are saying it's a strong nation, having strong base of young population. I'm worried. This is a strength or weakness. If we won't be able to give proper direction, proper orientation to these students, then it can become a weakness of the country. And in that case, the role of teachers are becoming very, very important. The challenge which are coming and the challenges which are in front of our teachers, and particularly I'm saying to management institutes and in management also PGDM institutes. In our country, we are having 300 plus management institutes. And from these institutes, roughly 100,000 students every year, they are coming out into the market. Total higher technical education, if I see the number of graduates who are coming out every year, it is around 1.4 million students every year, meaning management, pharmacy, architecture, arts, crafts, design. In higher education, only in technical education, I'm saying 1.4 million students are coming out into the market. Acceptance of those graduates, it is a very, very serious challenge. Many a time when we are discussing with industries, that you people, industries are saying the graduates who have come out from the academic institute, they have not been oriented according to their requirements. Many a times you are asking, what are your requirements? Please tell us. Being regulator, certainly it is a moral responsibility of ours that anyone who is crossing the gates of the higher educational institute, their acceptance should be quite high. But Indian universities are saying the contents which you are delivering inside the classes, the syllabus, the curriculum which you are having, it is outdated. They are saying change this curriculum. In our curriculum in management education, they are saying you are keeping the conventional marketing subjects or conventional finance subjects or organizational behavior, HR, or some component of information technology, the business communication, all those sort of contents you are keeping, some strategy part or economics. They are saying you change this thing. Everything is changing with a very rapid pace, and particularly the emerging area which is coming out, and that is in the form of artificial intelligence, data sciences, cyber security, robotics, all sort of content it has to be into your curriculum so that immediately when they are entering into our organization, they should be able to do justice with that one. Industries are saying that we are competing at global level, and Bhavguna ji will be endorsing this one. that industries are competing at global level. Their processes, their technologies, their quality, their cost, everything is of that repute. And certainly the human resource which they are receiving, they are saying that human resource is of not that reputation, which can handle all sort of problems which we people are facing into the industry or technologies which we are using. These friends are not able to do justice with that one. Second thing, industries are saying that practically students are weak. Theoretically, they may be quite sound, but as far as performing on the ground itself or taking the challenges, solving the problems, in those areas, your students are weak. And again, I'm saying management education without actions, there is no meaning of that one. Theory. Every day we are teaching in a class, in a week, some 30 hours theory we are teaching without giving any challenges into practical problems or case studies. That sort of education we are not providing. It means the industries, whatever they are saying, it is correct. Third one, they are saying the problem solving abilities of these friends. Madam director was saying that they have changed the assessment system of these friends. The assessment system, certainly our very old assessment system, we are having some 8 questions in the question paper. We are having out of that 5 questions friends will have to attempt. Even some 2 questions they are correcting. It means he has got some CGPA of 6 or 6.5, 7 like this one. And all the answers of all the problems are known to everyone. And those questions we are asking to this friend. Industries are saying we are not interested in those answers because everyone is knowing those answers. Industries are saying on the ground we are having hundreds of problems and all the answers of those problems are unknown. Unknown answers we want from the friends. If they can solve those type of problems, then certainly our requirement will be sorted out. When these type of questions were coming, Poguna Saab, we have given one assignment. We have given one assignment to Stanford University. We said, these industries are saying they are not happy with our talented mind. They are saying large number of gaps are there. Please do go into our academic institute. Please do find what are the shortcomings. And particularly in high order thinking skills. One is your academic skills where mugging it is being done and some answers are being given at the end of the examination. But high order thinking skills where industries are saying that critical thinking, problem solving abilities, decision making, in those areas, high order thinking skills where industries are giving suggestions, please do suggest us that what are the gaps. Team Stanford University started in 2018. They have gone into many of our schools, first of all, because the raw material which you are getting in higher education, that is from schools. So we said, you please enter into our schools and do judge the capabilities of our students, and mainly in these three areas, problem solving ability, decision making, and critical thinking. They have done this exercise, serious exercise they have done, and they have compared our students with Chinese and Russian students also, with same age group, with the same problem in that academic skills in mugging part, as well as in high order thinking skills. And just before this national education policy, they have submitted that report. According to their report, in low-order thinking skills, in mugging part, our students are comparable with Chinese students, comparable with Russian students, but inferior than Chinese students. Even in mugging part, I'm saying, even in remembering part, they are saying Indian students, school-going students, are inferior than Chinese students. But as far as these three higher-order thinking skills are concerned, problem-solving, decision-making, critical thinking, in these three areas, Indian students are far, far inferior as compared to Russian and Chinese friends, both. We were shocked, in fact, that one side we are saying Indian friends are most talented, they are doing wonders across the globe. Maybe our doctors, maybe our architects, maybe our lawyers, wherever they are going, they are bringing laurels for this country. When we try to analyze why our friends are unable to take decisions, we could find that our family system, in our family system, we never allow our children to speak. Whatever we parents are saying, it is correct. Our children at the age of 16 or 17, whatever it's saying, we are not permitting at all to speak them. Even in our school system, students are moving in a cube and doing some prayers in the morning in the class. They are sitting. Teachers are teaching one-way communication, no arguments, no cross-questioning. Even communication skills are being taught, but students are not allowed even to speak. That was the major challenge. But beautiful part of that report is They are saying when same children are entering into higher educational institute, when they are working in the teams, when they are working in the groups, when they are working on the projects, when they are doing some activities inside the hostels, when they are staying in hostels, sitting in the canteen, boys and girls, when they are discussing these issues, when certain level of freedom is there, when certain level of autonomy is there, that time learning curve for Indian students are much faster as compared to Chinese and Russian students. So my humble request to team IRN, give freedom. Children are talented, only we need to give appropriate environment to them. Certainly they'll do very, very special for the country. And this innovation and the product development or entrepreneurship is not being developed by our friend because their foundation itself is weak. You know, the innovation will be coming if their ideas are clear, if their concepts are clear, if their concepts are endorsed through practicals. But that environment, it has not been given to the student. So they are unable to take the challenges. They are unable to take the decision. So give freedom. And to PGDM institutes, I'm just coming to final points and to the students who are going out today. Certainly, they are having a certificate of success. It is not an ordinary document, A4 size paper. You are having enormous, enormous responsibilities on you people. When you were in academic institutes, many people were there around you to help you. But when you'll be in the work of world, you'll have to take challenges, you'll have to take decisions, you'll have to solve the problem. So keep on learning, keep on doing good work. This certificate which you have got, it is not the end. It is starting point of your delivery. Whatever knowledge you are having, it is just like a certificate to enter into world of work. But continuous learning every day or lifelong learning, it is very, very important. Even for teachers, today I may be a very good teacher, but tomorrow if I'm not updating myself, no one will be accepting me because things are changing with a very rapid pace. To PGDM Institute, we have given all sort of autonomy. Important part is financial autonomy. Even our academic institutes, PGDM Institute, they can charge fee according to the time and money which students are spending. The value of money, it has to be. Otherwise, they can charge. The students who are spending the time into their academic institute, their value, it has to be. So our PGDM institutes are autonomous institute, first and foremost thing is. Second one, the administrative autonomy. The board of governors, everything, they can decide. The visionary people, the talented people who can decide vision and mission of the institute, the PGDM institutes are having that sort of autonomy. So financial autonomy, administrative autonomy, even academic autonomy, the curriculum which is being decided, the changes in the curriculum, it is in the hands of the institutes. Nowhere universities are coming into picture. Universities may be stagnant, their decision may be slower, but these PGDM institutes are directly reporting to AICT. They are having all sort of autonomy. Even one model curriculum we have given, but it is not final. According to their requirements, they can change. And fourth autonomy, which we have extended to them, that once they have achieved some certain level of quality in terms of NB accreditation, then they are having autonomy to increase their seats also up to any extent till they are doing the justice with this friend, that sort of seat increase they can do. So whatever national education policy is saying, giving autonomy, that already our PGDM institutes are having, they are enjoying this one. So please do justice with this friend, that I'm saying. And finally, the industries are saying, we need people like Mahendra Singh Dhoni. We are asking what facility Mahendra Singh Dhoni is having. They are saying Mahendra Singh Dhoni is a cricketer. When he's having bat in his hand, he is doing justice with that one. Means core skills, the core competencies of the cricket, strong competencies he's having. Even when he's behind the wickets, he's taking a strong catches. So again, he's doing justice with that core skills which are needed. When question of team leadership, it is coming, he's a very good leader inside the ground or outside the ground. He's very popular and no question of any sort of rivalry against him. No, he's a very good leader. He's convincing everyone. Even when question of modeling is coming, he's a very good model also. So that is again all-rounder chip of that Mahendra Singh Dhoni. When question of coming in front of media is concerned, he's a very good orator. Again, he's doing justice with that job also. As far as his values are concerned, even sometimes when he's getting out, even umpire may be raising finger, even before that when he starts to move. So the value strong value system, he's following to this one. inside India when he is behaving in a different way, when outside India, when he is taking challenges of foreign teams, his behavior is something different, very strong, very aggressive, and always he is fighting for win of the country. So industries are saying we need those type of children who can do the betterment of our organization, who can take ownership of our institutes. And finally, to these friends who are graduating today, best wishes to everyone. They should be able to fly. They should be able to fly high. Lekin jab bhi aap udo, apne paav jameen pe rakhna. Aap is dharti ko, is dharti mata ko, aap is institute ko, aapke teachers ko, aapke parents ko, aapke dada dadi, kabhi aap bhulna mat. Bahut unche udna, par udte udte jameen apne jo hai paav jameen pe rakhna paav. Aur dusra, keep strong communication. Strong communication, it is most essential. The enthusiasm and communication and strong zeal, that is very important. The small example I am giving before finishing, the example of butterfly. Butterfly jo hoti hai, tikli jo hoti hai, wo agar aaj IRM Institute Jaipur se udna shuru kare, to 180वें din wapis wo wahan pe pahunchti hai. Ye uska jeevan ka uddeshya hota hai ki mere ko 180वें din IRM mein pahunchna hai, that target she achieves. But very, very special part in this story is the total lifespan of butterfly is only 30 days. Question aapka ye ho sakta hai ki 180वें din aayega fir kaun, 30 din baad to butterfly to mar jayegi. But before dying, the message which she gives to the next generation, she is saying that your target is to reach to IRM. Sixth generation of butterfly, it is reaching to IRM. And one reason for that one is they are having strong communication. And same time, the strong challenges which they are taking, uski wajah se unko kamyabi milti hai. Bachcho jahan pe bhi jaye, isko desh ko gaurvanvit karna, apne parents ko gaurvanvit karna, shikshakon ko kabhi nahi bhulna. Aap jo ho aaj, wo shayad parents ka itna role nahi ho jitna aapke upar shikshakon ka role hai. Inko kabhi bhi mat bhulna. Meri shubhkamnaye. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir, for your words of inspiration. I now request Dr. Stanley Thomas to administer the oath of integrity to the graduates.
I request all the graduates to kindly raise your right hand and repeat after me. As a business management professional, I solemnly affirm and pledge, in the name of God the Almighty, that I will use my knowledge and expertise gained at my alma mater to innovate new business policies and strategies for promotion of my own career and for the development of the nation. I will act with integrity and pursue my work in an ethical manner for social, economic, and environmental development. I will safeguard the interests of my shareholders, co-workers, customers, and the society in which we operate. I will manage my enterprise in good faith, guarding against the advancement of my selfish motives that may harm the organization that I serve. I will uphold, both in letter and in spirit, the laws and contracts governing my own conduct and that of my enterprise. I will develop both myself and other managers under my supervision so that the profession continues to grow and contribute to the well-being of the society. I will strive to prove worthy of my alma mater in words, deeds, and actions. May God help me in all my endeavors. Thank you.
I would request our guest of honor, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahugana, to address the gathering and inspire the graduates with words of wisdom.
Thanks a lot. I'm grateful. I'm actually grateful to the chairman, the council of directors, faculty members for inviting me as guest of honor. My sincere regards to Vice Chairman, sir, of AICTE, Dr. M.P. Punia ji, for educating me also during this particular address. We all learn from people of wisdom, from people, and still we are learning. I would like to reiterate that IRM was established in 1994. And I was a student from 1996 to 1998. So I was from the initial batches, which were blessed. I would reiterate, we were blessed by the presence of Dr. Thomas Kangan, who I believe is the visionary architect of rural management in India, after Dr. Kurian of Amul fame. During those times, Dr. Barbara Kangan was mother to all the students. We all came from different states, from different parts of India. And Barbara Kangan was mother to all of us. All our problems went to her and to Thomas Kangan, sir. And they very meticulously helped us move forward, learn the tricks of the trade. And the whole faculty members, Dr. Madan, Dr. Sapra, Dr. Rao, they all challenged us that, yes, you can do it. They believed in us. They believed in our talents. They believed in our skills. And yes, these outgoing students, I can tell you, you also have all the qualities in you. Just like Hanumanji, you only need to be told that it is in you. It is there. You will have to just identify, raise to the occasion when the challenges are there, and perform the best. My fellow friends like Dheeraj Agarwal, Vinay Bagadi, and many who passed out during those periods, who were there during the period, they all are doing great. You should be very confident. You are from an institute which gives a dual program. None of the other management institutes are giving you dual programs, PGDBM, as well as an exposure to the rural marketing system, to the rural world of India. And you know what is the size of the rural market in India? It is going to be 100 billion in 2025. So you are part of that $100 billion market, and you have $100 billion to manage with your hands, with your brains, with your skill set. It's been 23 years that our batch graduated. And today, what are they doing? Because you will become the next, and I think better than all of us. What are these guys doing? What are my friends doing? What are my batchmates doing from IRM? They are adding immense value. Where? In the banking sector, in the financial sector, in the rural development sector, in the agri-input sectors, in environment-related companies, in digital economy, in growing the digital economy, in bringing digitalization into India. So, as there is a Bollywood song which I really appreciate, Apna Time Aayega. And this is your time. And this is your time. Now the degree is in your hands. Now you are ready with the skill set. The only thing is you'll have to rise to the occasion to face the challenges and overcome them. It is your time. Apna Time Aayega. Today, India is self-sufficient in foods. Digitally, we are going to enter into a 5G arena. Pesticide sprays are being sprayed with the help of drones. Drone technologies are in India. We are visibly doing a lot of business, and a lot of adjuvant technologies entering into India, and drone technologies being used in agriculture. Latest agricultural practices are being used. Latest agri inputs are brought into India and farmers are using it. Nifty is trading at 17,700. Can we think of? Nifty is at 17,700. Sensex is 59,000 plus. So you all are in an environment, in a time in India when India is growing double digits. Corona or no corona, we are fighting them. We are overcoming them. You might be knowing, 150 crore we have crossed vaccination. Can any of the countries in the world do this? Or are able to do this? No. We are doing. We Indians are doing. And you all are part of this whole change. So we are getting gold medals in Olympics. Our players are doing great. Just now, Mr. Punia gave example of Mr. Dhoni. And there are many others whom we can recognize. Entrepreneurship. Shark Tanks, I think you might be seeing the show Shark Tanks. And I see the young minds of India coming up with creative technologies, with creative ideas to bring into India, which is a big, big market, and the world is looking towards India today. And you are the managers of today. Apna Time Aayega. So go and win the world. Go and win the world. Wishing you all the best for your career, for your success, and wherever needed, the hand-holding, we'll be there with you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging words. In my capacity as the registrar, I request the director, Institute of Rural Management, to present graduates for the conferment of postgraduate diploma in management and postgraduate diploma in rural management. I request the director that graduates awarded with various awards to be invited first, followed by the remaining graduates.
Madam President, permit me to present you to you in accordance with the grace passed by the Council of Directors of the Institute of Rural Management, the meritorious graduates whose names are hereby submitted for the award of gold and silver medal for excellence in academics and extracurricular performance.
By virtue of power vested in me as the President of the Institute of Rural Management, I hereby grant permission to award gold and silver medals to the meritorious graduates for whom approval has been accorded by the Council of Directors.
With the permission of the President, I would like to announce the names of the medal winners for academic session 2019-21. Dr. Thomas Memorial Gold Medal for All-Round Best Student of Session 2019-21 is awarded to Ms. Neha Baheti. Mr. Kundanmal Jain Memorial Gold Medal for First Rank in Business Management Program for Session 2019-21 is awarded to Ms. Muskan Jain. Mr. Kundanmal Jain Memorial Gold Medal for First Rank in Rural Management Program for Session 2019-21 is awarded to Ms. Kritika Jain. Dr. Stanlois Kangan Memorial Silver Medal for Second Rank in Business Management Stream, Session 2019-21 is awarded to Ms. Drishti Seni. Dr. Stanlois Kangan Memorial Silver Medal for Second Rank in Rural Management Stream, Session 2019-21 is awarded to Ms. Deepala Salvi. Madam President, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace passed by the Council of Directors of Institute of Rural Management, the graduates whose names are herewith submitted for the conferment of Postgraduate Diploma in Management and Postgraduate Diploma in Management, Rural Management.
By virtue of power vested in me, I hereby grant permission to confirm the diplomas to graduates.
I request Dr. Tanya to announce the names of the graduates for the award of PGDM diploma equivalent to MBA.
When the great scorer comes to write against your name, he writes not whether you lost or won, but how you played the game, calling out the students for one of the most important milestones of their lives. Abhishek Gupta, Aditi Jain, Aditya Kumar Singh, Akash Mathur, Akhil Sharma, Akshita Kedavat, Anamika Sen, Ankit Sharma, Ankita Singh, Anshul Jain, Arpit Khandelwal, Arpit Thakre, Arun Kumar, Arzu Jain, Ashutosh Singh, Avinash Kumar Mishra, Ayush Bari, Ayushi Agarwal, Chavi Mathur, Deeksha Agarwal, Dolly Garg, Drishti Saini, Isha Arora, Gaurang Lashkari, Gaurav Parikh, Gaurav Shrotriya, Gunjan Goyal, Gunjan Khandelwal, Harsh Vijay Vargia, Harshit Kedia, Hina Khan, Jyoti Singh, Kanishka Moyal, Khyati Singh, Manish Brijwal, Mansi Sharma, Mishita Sharma, Mohak Vijay, Monica Sharma, Monica Kumari Khyatani, Muskan Jain, Muskan Sharma, Naina Singh, Namisha Pariyani, Namrita Ojha, Neeraj Kumar, Neha Baheti, Neha Jain, Nikhat Bano, Nikita Agarwal, Nishant Jain, Nishtha Gupta, Piyush Goenka, Piyush Lata, Prachi Vijay, Prakhar Joshi, Praveen Sharma, Priya Mishra, Priyal Jain, Priyanshu Jain, Rahul Sharma, Rishabh Jain, Ritik Kulshresht, Ronit Singh, Samriddhi Jain, Sandeep Prabhakar Sharma, Shruti Sharma, Shubham Sharma, Shubham Sharma, Siddhant Jain, Sneha Jain, Sonam Bhopani, Sparsh Gupta, Supeksha Agarwal, Swati Gupta, Ujwal Jain, Vedika Soni, Vidya Kashliwal, Vijaya Shri Saini, Vikram Mathur, Vishnu Prasad P, Yamini Agarwal, Yash Parik.
I request Dr. Tanya to announce names of the graduates for award of Postgraduate Diploma in Management, Rural Management, Batch 2019-21.
Adesh Kumar Aman, Aditya, Ankit Chandrakar, Ayush Chauhan, Pagar Darshan Gorak, Dashrath Singh, Daulat Singh, Deepmala Salvi, Dikshant Chaturvedi, Disha Sharma, Gaurab Mohanty, Gopesh Kumar Jha, Kamlesh Shinde, Kapil Rewar, Kartik Pathak, Kritika Jain, Vatsal Maheshwari, Mahim Bhandari, Manish Saraswat, Nikhil Raj Patil, Poonam Devi, Prashant Dandge, Roshan Kumar, Sachin Kumar, Sumit Kumar, Vivek Kumar, Yogesh Sudam. Na thake abhi pair, na abhi himmat hari hai. Na thake abhi pair, na himmat hari hai. Hausla hai zindagi mein kuch kar dikhane ka, isliye abhi bhi safar jari hai. Thankfulness is the beginning of gratitude. Gratitude is the completion of thankfulness. Thankfulness may consist merely of words, but gratitude is shown in acts. As a token of respect and gratitude, we would like to felicitate our renowned chief guest, Dr. M.P. Punia sir, with a token of remembrance. We would like to extend our gratitude to our distinguished guest of honor, Mr. Sushil Kumar Bahuguna sir, with a token of remembrance. A heartfelt thank you to all the dignitaries for sanctifying this auspicious occasion with your magnificent presence. Your time and presence means a lot to us. I would like to invite Professor Gaurav Malpani for the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Dr. Tanya. We have gathered here on this august occasion of the 19th virtual convocation ceremony of FMS IRM to celebrate the gift of wisdom. On this special occasion, those who are present virtually and those who could not make it to be with us today, I take this opportunity to thank all those who have helped us. Allow me to begin by thanking our chief guest of the day, Shri M.P. Punia sir, Vice Chairman AICTE, our guest of honor, Shri Sushil Bahuguna, Sales and Marketing Leader, India, SAARC and SEA region, Dr. N. K. Sharma sir and Dr. Ashutosh Pant for accepting to grace this day with his presence. I must thank all of you for your very insightful addresses. Over the years, we have been fortunate enough to be backed by a strong alumni connect who have helped us, rather, I must say, their own institute in achieving new heights. It is a must to mention the consistent effort put in by team of very motivated, dedicated and qualified professors and lecturers, and also the leadership of Director Dr. Tarjini Goyal, who with their wealth of knowledge and experience have given our graduates a deep-rooted foundation in various fields of study. They have nurtured the talents and have stimulated us to think more critically. For this, we owe them a huge debt of gratitude. I extend my sincere gratitude to the Council of Directors, board members, members of Academic Council who have supported us in all practical ways and have guided us to be at this stage. Opinions in various forums, colleagues who have helped us to widen our intellectual scope and who supported us in many ways too great to forget. I also express my gratitude to those who are behind the scene, from the administration staff, the tireless faculty members and the support staff. Thank you all. Further, I take this opportunity to extend my most sincere thanks to all of our invited guests and parents who have joined us virtually. Thank you for being here with us to share in our joy. To our wonderful audience who have turned up in such an overwhelming numbers, we thank you also for your contribution. A hearty congratulations to all the awardees of the certificates. Each one of you have the potential to change the world. You all have grown up in powerful intellectuals who will make a massive footprint in the time to come. We sincerely thank you for your confidence and your continuous effort for the well-being of the institute and for the entire nation. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Madam President, I request for your permission to declare the e-convocation 2022 closed.
I permit.
With the permission of the President of the Institute of Rural Management, I hereby declare the e-convocation 2022 closed.
I request everyone to rise for the national anthem. I request the convocation procession to retreat.